All right, yet another uniform motion problem involving a car and a bus. And so again, remember, we're using the formula rate times time equals distance. Right, so what happens here? A car and a bus set out at 2 p.m. from the same spot headed in the same direction. So we're assuming they're leaving at the same time, going in the same direction. The car is going faster, twice as fast. So the picture is the car is going to get ahead. And how far ahead? 68 miles. So if the bus only went this far, there's another 68 miles left from where it ends to where the car is. So that's our picture. So now we want to get the information in a little chart here. So we have a bus and a car and a rate and a time. And the distance, rate times time equals distance. Okay, so the bus. What do we know about the bus? Well, for the rate. We know that the car is going twice as fast as the bus. That's all we know. So let's say the bus is x, then the rate of the car is twice as fast, 2x. Okay. Does it tell us how long they're going for? What's their time? It says after 2 hours. So yes, they both are driving for 2 hours. So the distance is rate times time. X times 2 is 2x. 2x times 2 is 4x. Alright, so the bus went 2x. So this is 2x, this little piece for the bus. And the car up here, that length is 4x. Now you got to look at the picture, see if you can write an equation by looking at the picture. So from here to here, notice that's 68. So 2x plus 68 has to equal that length for the car, its distance. So 4x is the same as 2x plus 68. So 2x is 68 divided by 2. X is 34. So that represents what? X represents the rate of the bus. All right, so let's check and see if this makes sense. With the bus, the car, rate, time, distance, easy to check. All right, now that we know what X is, the bus was going 34, so the car was going 68 miles per hour. They each were going 2 hours. The distance then would be rate times time equals distance. So that would be 68, and that would be 68 times 2, which is 136. So, is it true that the car is 68 miles ahead of the bus? Yes. So we go up here. The car went 136 miles, the bus went 68 miles, and that is, if I added that 68 more miles, that does add up to 136. Okay, what's the question though? Find the rate of the bus and the car. Right, so that's what it wants to know. The rate of the bus is 34 miles per hour. The rate of the car is 68 miles per hour.